Well, WDSU First Warning Weather, I'm sitting here looking at all the information because landfall is just any moment. Could be any second in the next couple of minutes. Unfortunately, what you're seeing here is this blinking purple area of Lake City. You may know it pretty well. If you drive the I-10, you're headed to Orlando for the family vacation. That's your turnoff. That is a confirmed tornado within that area. So what we've got right now is Tallahassee's high-def radar, and we can show you exactly how strong these winds are at this time. They are just incredible, and I guesstimated a little bit earlier that they were about 1,000 feet off the ground. These are about 2,000 feet off the ground, so you have to take a little bit of the wind speeds off from there. We found winds 112, 111, 113, some areas where it's even stronger, 114. What about on the back side of this here? 103 and still 93, so the winds on the west side not as strong, which is typical. You get the aided velocity of the winds in front of you here, too. I heard something printing off and want to see if that is the official word. I don't think it is right now, so we'll move ahead. We've got incredible rain rates with this too. Take a look at this. We've got rainfall that is on the order of just 4, 5, 6 inches of rain possible. So different radar styles, we can put these into different modes, and with the raindrop size of where they are, there it is, 7 inches per hour, and that is probably right on. 6 inch per hour rain rates right along this outer eyewall as it moves through. The other part of this is the rain that's already fallen. Now what happened is the storm has taken a little bit more of a northeast turn recently. Instead of going to the original projections that had it a little bit farther west in between Perry and Panama City, Apalachicola's down here, Sop Choppy's around here. And we've got some really incredible rainfall totals that have already come in, already over 14 inches, and we still have more rain to come on that too. So this is quite the situation. If there is some good news out of this, and you go back to radar imagery, I can show you. It's this outer wall that has made landfall and is going through uninhabited areas, unpopulated areas. So this is a wildlife preserve right here. But I'll tell you, the city and the town of Perry has gotten hit really hard. Really quickly, let me just put a storm track on here going north and show you who's in line for this 24, 25 miles per hour. That's a pretty rural area. There isn't anybody within here that's showing that you'll have that storm moving your way. So that's also some good news. Very small towns. And it looks like it is just the worst of Tallahassee. We'll miss that. So we'll be keeping our eye out for what's going to happen. Landfall imminent at any moment. So we move ahead. There it is. There's the satellite imagery. And we look for the less humid and cooler air. That's kind of a preview of what's to come for us. But the latest track will show that we've got Georgia still dealing with hurricane force winds. Albany, southwest part of the state, still tropical storm status as it moves into Atlanta. Maybe you're thinking, game, this is having an effect. We've already reported no. We're going to go on just fine. 8 a.m. is when it moves through on Friday. Plenty of time to recover, but this is still dropping tons of rain in the Tennessee Valley. So these are hurricane force winds that extend out 60 miles from the center of where it is right now. In the yellow, you're seeing tropical storm force winds that extend out 310 miles. This is the worst part of the storm, is that tropical storm force wind status for you, and it's going to affect tons of cities over the southeastern United States. Our forecasts out of Europe and the United States have done extremely well showing the storm's path and movement. In fact, the eyewall it's shown has done really well. There's the hurricane warnings. There's the tropical storm warnings. We still have storm surge warnings, of course, multiple tornado watches, tons more rain to come. We're looking at 15, 16, maybe upwards of 20 inches of rain for bullseye spots to come in. So we are far from done, even with the rainfall or with the landfall that's just coming in.